It can be quite difficult to know how you can do a realistic career mode in FIFA 22 and how you can keep the save realistic throughout the years. I personally like to keep my career mode semi-realistic to combine having fun and realism mixed into one. In this video I will show you how I play career mode and tips that you can use in your own saves. If you go in and enjoy the video, then be sure to give it a like and subscribe to my channel to not miss any other career mode tips. Now let's get into it. First off, you need to set yourself some limits on how realistic you want your career mode to be. If you want to keep it very realistic, then you can only sign 3 players in each season and sell 2 for example. Or that you are only able to spend 50% of your transfer budget. These are all quite specific rules that limit your freedom in a career mode, but does make sure that your save keeps being very realistic. You can also go overboard on the other hand and make the save very unrealistic by not having a limited amount of transfers and signing 15 new players in a transfer window, or by signing every high potential wonder kid that's in the game. In my experience, I don't really like either side, so I try to stay somewhere in the middle. I don't sign many high potential wonder kids at all, I even actively try to not sign any in most of my career modes. Sometimes though, especially when you get further in the save, it's kinda hard to not buy any of them. I also don't have any limits on the amount of transfers I can make in a season, however, I try to sign most of the players I want to buy for that season in the first window and sign a maximum of 1 player in the January transfer window. Sometimes I sign like 8 players at the start of a new season, but those also include younger players or regens that I loan out immediately. It's important to set your own limits and see what fits. If you feel like signing 7 or more players in a season is too much for you, then lower it down to 4 or 5. If you feel like your transfer budget is too big because you sold one of your best players and have a huge advantage in comparison to teams similar to you, then don't spend all of it and have a percentage left over at the end of the season. If you just spend all the money instantly, then you will all of a sudden have a lot more quality over other teams, which might make it too unrealistic too quickly. So when you started your career mode and want to keep it fun and realistic at the same time, it's important which players you sign. When you look at your starting team, you can see the player's rating. Most of the starting 11 will have quite a similar rating, some players will have a higher rating, and some will have a lower rating. Adjust the signings of the first 2 or so seasons to these ratings. Don't buy a player that's 5 ratings above the average rating of your starting 11, because you don't see that happen in real life very often. When you are into the 3rd season or have gotten promoted to the highest division of that country, then it can be acceptable to sign 1 or 2 higher rated players. You can slowly add these higher rated players to your squad throughout each season, and the player's quality can grow with the club's growth. As the club you are managing got promoted, won a cup, or just had a couple of seasons with good results and improvements in the league table. The best way to sign realistic-ish players are through the global transfer network. When you start up your new career mode, a few scout instructions have already been put in place and your scouts have been sent out to a few countries. I'd suggest to first take a good look at your entire squad, see in which position you need an improvement to strengthen your squad or where you maybe need a backup player. So if you need to add or change some instructions for your scouts, and see where the scouts have been sent to. When looking at the countries the scouts have been sent out to, it might be difficult to figure out in which leagues you need to buy players from in order to keep it realistic. I would suggest to look up about the transfer history of the club or check your current squad's nationalities. If I am noticing there aren't any English or French players in my team, for example, which is playing in a lower division in Germany, then obviously I shouldn't buy many of these players and definitely not send my scouts to those countries. For St. Pauli, for example, you notice there are a lot of German players in the squad, which is quite obvious as the team is from Germany. With lower league teams, they normally sign players from neighborhood countries, so countries that are close to the original country. For Germany, that is the Netherlands, Denmark and Austria, to name just a few examples. So as I figured that out, I sent my scouts to these countries and I bought players from these countries. Then you of course have to wait a few days to see scout reports with players in the global transfer network. I search through them, remove wonder kids or players that are too high rated or too expensive, and mostly remove players without a 2D phase 2, as I prefer players to have one. I then scout the players that look interesting to me and add them to my shortlist, and later on, when they have been fully scouted, I take another look at the player's stats and buy the players I want. Of course also looking at the ratings of each player to make sure it's quite similar to the players of my starting 11. Using the global transfer network has given me a lot of hidden gems over the past few FIFAs that I've really enjoyed using and been surprised by how good they are I have become. Would highly recommend to use this instead of using websites that show players' potentials, as it's also more fun to find new players you have never heard of and see them turn into beasts in career mode. The most difficult thing to keep a career mode going is to have the right difficulty and sliders. I currently play on Ultimate with no change to the sliders. I do have Competitor mode turned on, which makes the AI do more skills and make it more difficult, as I find the regular Ultimate difficulty a bit too easy. And since this FIFA, there's also a feature called player based difficulty, which I have turned on. This means that the best players on the AI team will have more intelligence while they are being controlled, and so make better choices when passing or shooting the ball, or when they are defending. combination of these two makes up for some very tough but fun matches in my St. Pauli career mode I currently have going on, and what you might have seen across my Twitter and Instagram account recently. If ultimate difficulty is too difficult for you, then lower it to the legendary or maybe even world class, whatever suits you the best and makes up for a good challenge while still having fun at the same time. You can also move around with some of the sliders and see if that improves your gameplay. Whilst it's often fun to bring in the young, basic talents that you have on your bench during a game, it's not very realistic a lot of the times. When you just signed up a player from your youth academy who has a decent rating and has a lot of pace, you most likely want to use them instead of the older, slower player that's been at the club for 10 plus years. So when you sign new players or sign up youth academy players, you shouldn't immediately put them in the starting 11 or have them as the first sub to come on during the next match. Instead, you should slowly add them into the squad by having them in the reserves for the first few matches, then add them to the bench, then let them play a couple of minutes, which eventually turns into half an hour or something. And if they are good enough, maybe even put them in the starting 11. You also shouldn't stop using the players that have been at the club for a longer time all of a sudden. Having new players at the club is fun and exciting, but it's not very realistic to not give the veterans or club loyal players any minutes anymore. You can decide to slowly ease them out of the team, giving them less and less minutes each month or so, and each season sell one or two of these older players. If you have watched a couple of my other videos, then you know I really like to use storylines, so fictional stories that I make up in my head. It's important to decide where you are putting the bar of realism and fun in your career mode. For example, I added Youssoufa Moukoko to St. Pauli before I started a career mode with them. Moukoko is one of the biggest wonder kids in the world right now, so of course he wouldn't join a German second division side. Well, I made up a storyline where he is returning to his first youth team, which is St. Pauli. I thought of a storyline where he didn't feel at home at Borussia Dortmund, or he didn't get enough playing time there and decided to go back to St. Pauli. Of course this isn't realistic at all, but creating a storyline around it helps to make it slightly more believable. And as I just really wanted to try him out in FIFA 22, I added him to St. Pauli. This is of course still not very realistic, but it is more fun for me, which is also very important. I've added another smaller storyline to it, that if I don't get promoted to the Bundesliga in the first two seasons, that I have to sell him again. So now you get a bit more what I mean with where you need to put the bar of realism and fun in your save. For this instance, I went more onto the route of fun instead of realism, but I have decided to balance it out a bit more and be even more realistic with the other transfers that I make in the save. Of course, there are many other storylines you can create to make your save more fun, more realistic or more challenging. Because if your past player's release clause gets paid right at the start of season 1, it might be more realistic to let him go instead of renewing his contract and keeping him at the club. Especially if you are a club like St. Pauli that isn't playing in the highest division and another club that does play in the first Bundesliga wants to buy one of your players. It's probably more realistic to let him go and try to fill that hole with a new player that you've never heard of. One thing I've started doing in my St. Pauli career mode is to play players that I like to use instead of using players who are higher rated. Normally you just put the highest rated players in your starting 11 instead of the lower rated ones. In my career mode, I've started to pay more attention to each player and how they perform in game. When I notice a lower rated player is performing better than a higher rated player, then I give the lower rated player a chance in the starting 11 to prove himself. If he performs well for a few matches, then he stays in the starting 11. If not, then I give the higher rated player another chance. This way I don't just use the more talented players because they are both younger and higher rated, but I keep using all the players who might be lower rated but perform better when I use them. This of course makes your career mode more realistic as well, as you're picking players who are in better form over players who might have more quality. This is definitely important if you're fighting for promotion to a higher division, just like I am in my St. Pauli career mode. Do you have any other tips that you use in your career mode to keep it realistic and fun at the same time? Let me know in the comments and you might just help some other players as well. If you thought this video was helpful, then be sure to give it a like and subscribe to my channel to not miss any other career mode tips, and I will see you at the next video.